It's day 46, and I have binged everything. There is nothing left, and I'm starting to deteriorate.
Psst! Over here! What if I told you that there was more binge-worthy entertainment? It's just hidden away. But I know a guy. Take this.
Binge Corp. An evil conglomerate. The top 1% of the top 1%. They have access to some of the richest entertainment and peddle it away to their offshore Netflix accounts, while others suffer in boredom and ignorance. Today I'm going to change that by hacking into their mainframe and sharing their watch history with the rest of the world. I've hooked onto a lead, a guy called Video Boy. Little does he know, his life is going to change today. He won't have exclusive access to his top-tier entertainment library anymore. Step 1. Identify the target and its flaws. There are always flaws. Step 2. Build malware and unleash an attack. Step 3. A reverse shell two-stage exploit. Load the malware into a femtocell delivery package. The perfect hack. Step 3.
Dinner's ready, pumpkin. Come on downstairs and turn off your game.
Mum, I'm hacking. I can't just pause it. Step 4. I'm in. Well, what's this? This guy has clocked over 30 hours in the Outer Worlds. He's watched countless episodes of a sci-fi show called Westworld. I love sci-fi. Might need to check that out. Here it is. His most binged show. Mr. Robot. He even left a review. Perfect. Mr. Robot is a moody psychological thriller full of twists and turns. It's about a hacker named Elliot Alderson, who with his group is trying to bring down the biggest conglomerate in the world and give power back to the people, all while struggling with severe social anxiety and depression. The show is very character-centric, often using dialogue-driven scenes to convey the plot. Not to mention that these scenes are filmed with unconventional methods to make you feel uneased. It's full of action, espionage, drama, and most importantly, lots of hacking. What's interesting about Mr. Robot is that unlike your average viewing experience, Elliot is often breaking the fourth wall and referring to us, the viewer, as his friend.
Hello, friend. Hello, friend. That's lame. Maybe I should give you a name.
We see the world through the eyes of Elliot, and it can be quite a dark place. Ever wonder what Fight Club would be like if Edward Norton were a hacker? Watch Mr. Robot. Hang on a second. There's more.
We've been in lockdown for months now. I have no idea when I'm gonna see my friends again, or when I'm next gonna get to go to a convention. I need something to cheer me up.
Sad and low, I just put on my favorite show, a show that always makes me feel so great. Romance, comedy, and tunes will help to fill long afternoons of waiting for this pandemic to end.
Don't worry, I'm not going to write an entire review in song. I'm not Rachel Bloom. Crazy Ex-Girlfriend is a musical romantic comedy about lawyer Rebecca Bunch, who moves from New York to West Covina, California, in pursuit of her high school sweetheart, Josh Chan. though she claims the move has nothing to do with him. The series follows Rebecca as she attempts to reconnect with Josh, all while making new friends, and boyfriends, in California. As the series progresses, her attempts at a romantic relationship with Josh become more and more disastrous. It has relatable and cleverly written characters, as well as fantastic songs written by Rachel Bloom and the late great Adam Slasinger. The cast features Rachel Bloom in the title role, who is known for her YouTube song parodies such as F*** Me Ray Bradbury and a personal favourite of my 14-year-old self, I Steal Pets. Alongside her are Donna Lynn Champlin as Paula, Rebecca's best friend slash mother figure, Santino Fontana as Greg, the sarcastic and pessimistic barkeep who ends up falling for Rebecca, and Vincent Rodriguez III as Josh, Rebecca's childhood sweetheart. And that's just to name a few. Crazy Ex-Girlfriend is a joyous and bittersweet story that sings its way through a journey of female friendships, mental health, and the pursuit of happiness. It just makes me want to sing. Why not see for yourself why I love this show so much? And don't forget to leave a comment down below.
The system's trying to dig out one more file. It's corrupted. This is what they tried to delete.
Go as creative as you want with the filmmaking. Filmmaking.
It echoed through my head. A challenge. Nay, a promise. I had done a recommendations piece to camera before, but this felt different. What could I say? How to convey what I love about American sitcom TV series Community? Is it the comedy, the cast of hilarious characters, or the ongoing self-referential nods to pop culture and TV cliches? No. It was so much more. I needed to go further, to do what Community does best. I needed to make a concept episode. You know, where the show would ditch its basic premise in favour of satirical spin on some other highly codified genre? That. Hi everyone! So the show revolves around seven friends who all attend Greendale Community College. A lawyer whose law degree was a scam goes to college to... A fun cast of students join his study group, which leads... It is now available on Netflix, as well as Amazon Prime and Hulu. Does anyone watch Hulu anymore? If you love 80s action cinema, buddy cops, or mafia movies, this show tackles all of... I'm sorry, this is... Just turn it off. It felt so cheap. Sitting. Talking. How could I do a piece to camera when I couldn't find peace myself? Boris, do you know how to fix the microphone on my laptop? It's doing that thing again.
I call it the crazy quilt of destiny. Mostly because the loom of fate was already taken.
Imogen, you've spent 24 hours on this voiceover, and the video was only meant to be 2 minutes. Nobody asked for perfection.
Well, perfection is what you're getting. And if you don't like it, you can fire me.
I'm surrounded by assassins. But when this is over, everyone will know that Community was described as snarky and fast-paced with a surprisingly tender undercurrent and an engaging cast. Everyone. Community is great. Go and check it out.
I feel like these bingers just get weirder every time. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. We hope you enjoyed that. As always, let us know what you've been bingeing down in those comments. Smash that subscribe button, and we'll see you in the next one.